Hi everyone, I hope you all are doing good. My name is Maitrisha and I welcome you back to my channel. Now today's video is more like one-on-one discussion with you virtually. And in today's video, we will be discussing about how can you know your body well, meaning how can you keep yourself physically and mentally fit. When I say knowing your body well means you have to understand how can you know what your body needs, how much does it need and why does it need. Now, I'm not a fitness instructor nor a yoga teacher, but over the time, I have started understanding the voices that my body gives to me. Do please watch this video till the end because I'm going to share with you some of my personal tips and my story, which I have understood and which I have learned over the time. Now, while you watch this video, do please hit the subscribe button and also bell icon so that you get notified whenever I post my next video. Now, isn't it true that we care a lot about people around us? Meaning, we try to take care of their food habits, we try to keep them happy by going over the board and doing everything that we can. But this case is not true when it is about ourselves. We don't give enough efforts in keeping ourselves happy physically and mentally. If you are someone who is trying and who is struggling to keep yourself physically fit and mentally fit, then do please watch this video till the end because there are few things that I have started implementing which are like very small efforts but are surely helpful and will hardly take 15 to 20 minutes of your daily life. So talking about physical fitness, we all know the importance of exercising or running or walking, whatever is best suitable for our body. So from past 5 months, I have realized that I have started gaining weight, which is like such a good news for me because from past 7-8 years, I was stuck on 51 kgs. Now in past 5 months, I have gained around 4 kg. So everyone around me have been telling me that the extra chubbiness looks good on me, but there's something that started hitting me off. The extra fat that I have gained has started giving me trouble, and that is the voice that I have started listening to from my body. Now, as much as this extra weight makes me feel good because I look good, the same extra weight makes me feel lazy. Now, when I sit down on the floor or when I'm doing something for like 1 hour, when I'm standing for an hour, I suddenly start feeling that weakness in my body because my body was not used to carrying extra weight within itself. Now, this started giving me an alarming situation. It made me feel that even though if I feel looking good, it is more important that I feel being good from inside, meaning I should be able to keep myself physically fit so that even the amount of extra weight that I have gained makes me feel strong and not lazy. So now I have started doing exercise, which I'm still not very consistent at. So I am not sharing that with you what I'm doing right now. But for sure, once I start seeing the result in my body and once I start being consistent, I'm going to share whatever I'm doing right now. So it is more about the voice that I'm listening to right now from my body. I remember right from childhood when I used to complain a lot about having a headache or having a stomachache or having any injury in my body or having any kind of pain, my mom used to tell me that you have to develop the habit of listening to your body. Your body gives you sign of what is going inside you. Meaning if you're having a stomachache, it is basically going to be because of the food that you eat. So you have to also watch the food that you eat. You have to be consistent on the habits, especially on the food habits that you develop. And that's how my habit of listening to my body and knowing my body started right from childhood. Now, during this time, this extra chubbiness makes me feel so good because now I'm finally not able to fit in my old clothes so that I can buy new clothes. But at the same time, it is also making me feel so weak from inside. And that's the only purpose of me now starting the physical fitness journey. Now, talking about mental fitness, we all know the benefits of meditation. Meditation can really help us calm our mind, and the breathing exercises can also help us calm our body. But for me, meditation is very hard. I can't sit down and close my eyes and try to meditate or listen to the chanting music and meditate. It wasn't happening naturally. And so I thought that maybe I should buy a couple of things that can help me meditate regularly. So I bought this affordable things from the market and which started helping me in meditating. So the first thing, talking about candles, I believe all the girls are addicted to having scented candles at their home. But now talking about waterfall, it is also very important to have waterfall in your house from Vastu point of view because it helps create positive energy. Now the way I meditate using these two things is, before going to bed every night, I lit the candle and I also start the waterfall and I turn off the lights of my room. I just sit down on my bed and close my eyes. Now this aroma of this scented candle and also the sparkling and sweet voice of the waterfall gives me positivity and it also helps me focus on just those two things and to not think about anything else. For me, meditation is more about shutting my mind from all the other things and just focusing in that particular moment, whatever is there with me. So these two small things really help me get that focus on the right thing. And during the time that I meditated, it is hardly around 10 minutes. I just try to focus on the aroma of the candle and also on the sweet voice of the water flowing from this mini waterfall. I believe these two investments are really going to help you a lot in your mental health and in keeping your mind and your body more positive. Whether it is physical fitness or mental fitness, there is one thing which is very common in both, and that is consistency. I feel that most of us might have thought in past or might have been thinking today of consulting a dietitian or going to a yoga class or taking the gym membership so that we can stay physically and mentally fit. But what about consistency in both the things? Haven't we all realized that the moment we stop following what our dietitian recommends or we stop doing the yoga or we stop going to gym, our body starts going back to the older shape? The moment you stop thinking about following those things is when you have to listen to your body. Because your body needs consistent amount of effort to keep yourself physically and mentally fit and strong. Just the way you need money for survival, your body also needs fuel to keep itself charged and energized. So when you start doing something new, make sure that you consistently follow it. Just the way I told that I'm still not consistent, but I'm trying to be consistent. It has been a couple of days that I have started following things consistently. So I have realized that there's that voice within me which keeps on telling me that the moment I stop doing things which I am doing for my mental and physical fitness, I start feeling weak, I start feeling negative, and I start feeling that palpitations of things not going good for myself. Having discussed about my physical and mental journey, I hope that this video motivates you in starting or in consistently following your physical and mental fitness journey. And if you have any such story to share, if you have faced something similar, or if you're trying something new to stay physically and mentally fit, then do please comment below so that we get a chance to discuss virtually. And if you're not so comfortable in commenting below, feel free to message me on Instagram. If you like this video, do please like, comment, and subscribe to my channel, and also share it with your friends who are struggling to stay physically and mentally fit. Thank you so much for watching my video. Stay tuned till next Wednesday.